It's a curve. It's a stone. It's a sausage. It's a zebra. Oh, I know, it's a bee. Hi everyone, and welcome to my channel. This video explains the main concepts for implementing a game like Quick Draw. It's a well-known online game that challenges players to draw a doodle, and then artificial intelligence guesses what the drawings represent. To learn how to make this game, just keep watching. To make this game, I used machine learning and a convolutional neural network, trained on a small subset of the free QuickDraw dataset. It is programmed in JavaScript, using Phaser and Tensorflow. The complete source code is available on GitHub. And you can play it on my official website. Just check the links in the video description below. Now, let's explore the entire game. As we see, the main screen is divided into three sections. The left section shows the graphs of accuracy and loss during training, so we can monitor how the model improves over time. The middle section shows the predictions made on testing samples. Here, the correct predictions are shown in green rectangles, and the incorrect predictions are red. There are also a button to initiate more training, and a button to predict the next samples. The right section contains a drawing area, where you can draw your masterpiece with the mouse. Below your drawing, the neural network output is displayed, hopefully showing a correct prediction. There are also two more buttons, one for clearing the drawing, and the other for a shameless self-promoting my other games. Finally, the status bar at the bottom shows the current game status with a corresponding message. Now, let's get started with explaining this project. As always when dealing with neural networks, the first thing is getting data. Otherwise, there is no learning. So, to train my neural network for recognizing doodles, I downloaded the Google QuickDraw dataset. It's a free collection of 50 million drawings, across several hundreds different categories. For this project, I needed grayscale bitmap images, size of 28 by 28, stored in NumPy format. Furthermore, to keep things simple, I used only three categories. Car, fish, and snowman. Then, I reduced these datasets by extracting only 500 images from each category. In that way, I made the learning process even more simpler and faster. Finally, I split all the datasets in such a way that 80% formed the training data and the remaining 20% formed the test data. This animation shows the principle of the car dataset splitting. Here is shown the fish dataset splitting. And here is shown the snowman dataset splitting. The last step in data preparation is shuffling. The benefits of data shuffling are ensuring random distribution, improving model quality, and increasing predictive performance. Once the data is ready, the next step is building a convolutional neural network model. Here I used a sequential model type, where the outputs of one layer are the inputs to the next layer. So, let's build the model. The input is a black-white image, with size of 28 by 28 pixels. The first layer is convolution with 8 filters. The second layer is max pooling, to reduce the data from the previous layer. The third layer is another convolution, now with 16 filters. The fourth layer is another max pooling. The fifth layer is flatten, to flat all data from the previous layer in one dimension. The sixth layer is dense, which represents all outputs. Finally, the softmax activation function selects the output node with the best confidence score. Now, it's time for the training algorithm. So, the training is performed through a number of iterations by fetching batches of samples from the training data. Similarly, but after every few cycles, the model is validated by fetching batches from the testing data. Here is an example of the training batch. Let's suppose the size of the training batch is 25. That means one batch contains 25 input images and 25 corresponding output labels. Since the size of each image is 28 by 28, then we send 25 times 784 pixels to the input. To the output side, we send 25 corresponding labels. Here, each label is a vector with the size equal to the number of classes. In this case, we have three classes. This vector is generated by using a method known as one-hot encoding, where all elements are zero, beside one element which points to the correct class. For instance, let's take a look at the first column. Here, the input image is a fish, and its output label is a vector with all zero fields, except for the fish field, which is set to 1. And here is an example of the testing batch, used for the model validation. It has a smaller size, but the structure is the same. So, let's train the model. This is the game screen, after implementing training algorithm. Currently it only shows the loss and accuracy graphs, so we can monitor how the model improves over time. As we see, the accuracy as the percentage of correct predictions, increases towards the 0.1. The loss, as a measure of how far predictions are from their labels, decreases towards the 0.0. Once the training is completed, the model is ready for making predictions. So, this is the game screen after adding the middle section. Here, we can see the predictions made on the testing samples. The correct predictions are colored green, and the incorrect ones are shown in red color. It seems almost all predictions are green, so we can conclude that our model is trained pretty well. Now, it's time to implement an interface for drawing doodles with mouse. At first we need to define a painting area and a pencil. Then we use mouse coordinates to generate a smooth line between each two points. Here is the algorithm. Let's denote the first point as P1 and draw a circle at that point. The size of the circle is equal to the pencil size. Next, let's denote the second point as P2 and draw a second circle at that point. By drawing circles at the endpoints, we ensure that a line has rounded corners. Now, calculate the midpoint M and draw a quadratic curve between points P1 and M. Finally, draw a quadratic curve between points M and P2. So, let's draw some art paintings now. Well, it looks like everything is ready to predict our own doodles. But before sending an image to the input of the neural network, we need to scale it down to the input size of 28 by 28. Here, the first step is cropping the original drawing. That means cutting blank borders away while keeping the image in a square frame. In the next step, the cropped image is gradually downsampled. Finally, a white border is added to get the desired input size of 28 by 28. Now, let's draw some doodles and take a look at the prediction results. Oh yeah, it's a fish. Yes, it's a car. Oh, I know, it's a snowman. In the last part of this tutorial, we will check if the game can recognize more different doodles. That means we need to retrain the model with a larger dataset. For instance, let's use these 10 categories. So, after retraining the network, it should be able to predict doodles from these 10 categories. Well, I hope so. Let's take a look. The first action is retraining. And then, the real fun begins. Let's go. Excellent, the game works pretty well, and our convolutional neural network successfully recognizes different doodles. The complete source code is available on GitHub, just check the links below. It's fully commented, so you can easily find out how I converted all the previously explained concepts into a functional code using JavaScript and TensorFlow. So, if you've enjoyed this video, please give me a big thumbs up and share it, and perhaps subscribe to my channel. Now let me know what you think about this project by leaving a comment below. Have fun, and see you in my next video.